The forming of the rings began on Middle-earth. The strength and will to govern each race were their worth. Elves, dwarves, humans all got rings since the ring's birth. Each race, they all became the lord of them things first. Then a dark lord named Sauron from the land of Mordor forged his own ring from the fires of Mount Doom's core. Compared to the others, this one ring was feared way more, was created more powerful than those that came before. There was a great war from Middle-earth that began. It was between Sauron versus the elves and also man. Once defeated, the dark lord's ring got stolen by man. His plan was to keep a hold of it as long as he can. As time went on, the ring got passed on down from man to a creature named Gollum who came around. Later, the ring by Bilbo, a hobbit, was found. Once discovered, he decided to take it to the Shire, his town. Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability. Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability. The hobbits were peaceful folk who stayed in the Shire, Frodo was the nephew of Bilbo, his uncle who he admires. When Bilbo traveled out the Shire for a goal that was higher, to his nephew Frodo he left behind his ring, his once desire. Gandalf was a wizard friend of the hobbits, especially Frodo. He warned him because of the ring he had to leave the Shire and go. So Frodo left town along with Sam, his hobbit friend also. During their trip, two hobbits ran to them who wanted to follow. The group stops at an inn where they meet a ranger named Strider, who helps them escape the nine, a bunch of dead spirit riders. While on the journey they get stopped again by the ghost outsiders. This time Strider fights them off with his sword and fire. Frodo gets wounded in the fight by a poisonous blade. An elf woman finds Frodo hurt and rushes to get his life saved. Frodo's taken to Rivendell, a city which the elves made. After healing up, Frodo meets up with his crew as the day fades. Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability. Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability. Nine warriors, including Frodo, are now set off on a mission to destroy the ring, put all its power out of commission. They head to the dwarf mines where they face some friction. A huge octopus they had to fight forced into submission. They reach a dwarf tomb where they battle orcs left to right. As they exit the mines, Gandalf falls in a pit, dark as night. The crew end up in a forest where the elves give them a fright. The elves help them journey by a river in a boat small and light. Once ashore, they get into it with some orcs that pop up. One of the human warriors falls to arrows that knock him up. The two hobbits are taken hostage by the orcs, get caught up. There are now only five warriors left since they got brought up. The elf, the dwarf, and Strider decide to go after the orcs quick, so they can recover the two hobbits that were taken hostages. Frodo goes along with Sam to get the mission accomplished, heading to Mount Doom and Mordor to get the ring abolished.
Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability. Who wants to be the lord of them things? Get to hold all that power that's in them rings. This is no game, it's a huge responsibility. Can turn your life around if you really want that ability.